First Corinthians chapter 16, verses 1 to 4, where Paul does talk about how it is important as a church to help people who are needy within Jerusalem. So when you look at the history of the church also looks after a lot of widows. They used to take care of a large number of widows. So what was Paul trying to say was that it is the responsibility of a local church to also take care of the needs of those who may be needy, or the needs of materialistic needs of the others within the church. So what is the application that we have? As a church, our responsibility, yes, of course, is to give to our local church, to give towards the preaching of the word, to the spiritual needs of the word, to missions, all of that, for the growth, for the extension of God's kingdom. Along with that, also to give to the materialistic needs of those who may have a need within the church. He's written this letter to the Corinth church when he was in Ephesus, okay? And he's telling them, he's saying, you know, I do plan to come to Corinth. Through these plans, what does he do? If you look with me on verse 7, there are four key words that says. It says, if the Lord permits. So even with these plans, even through these plans, he's following God's leading. So while he's writing that, he's saying, I still need to hear from God about this plan. And he's saying that if the Lord permits, if the Lord wills, I will do this or I will not do that. Paul actually gives a reason why he wishes to stay back in Ephesus. He says, for a great and effective door has opened to me, and there are many adversaries. So Paul is actually saying that there is something that has opened up for him. It says a great, okay, so this is not a literal wooden door, right? It is an opportunity. It's something that's Paul is probably standing in front of. It's a effectual door. It's a mighty door. It's probably a door of blessing. It's an opportunity that's coming his way that he does not want to miss. Talking about the importance of that opportunity, and he's saying it's important to recognize it and even respond at it. He's telling the church, hey church, I want you to encourage people or young ministers who will be visiting you. So what are we supposed to be doing? How is this a lesson for us? So maybe this is more for those of us who are maybe older, you know, and we see younger people ministering. I think we should encourage, we should endorse young people to just go out for the Lord. The first one is watch. Okay. A watch has many meanings, but here it talks about how to keep awake, to be vigilant, to be on your guard, and to be not surprised by your enemies. So the word watch does come, like it's like a timeless duty that we are supposed to do. Okay, let's look at the second one. It says, stand fast in the faith. So it's saying, stand firm in the faith. Hold on to what you have received. Hold on to the truth that you know, the truth of the gospel that you know. Hold on to it. Do not be disorderly. Keep your ranks, keep close together. Okay, so keep close together again is standing firm in your faith, knowing what your faith is about and living out that faith. Third says, be brave. That's exactly what Paul is again saying. Be brave so that you will press forward and you will conquer. And the last one he talks about is be strong. Okay? Be strong. It again means to increase your strength, to be fit, to ensure that you, you know, if there is anything that you see that's weakening you, that's what you strengthen and go on all for it. Okay?